This is me. Walking in a very rainy day to an active construction site. What am I doing? Well, we're about to find out. Welcome to Martin Place Station. A station which is very, very grand, as you can see. Martin Place is part of the new metro extension that is planned to be in service by July this year. This will go from Chatswood to Sydenham Metro Station. We walk here where the Opal card indicators have sadly turned off. At this concourse platform, there are also Sydney Metro indicator. Now, let us go down to the actual platform level. We're going down on the escalator, and as you can see, a lot of people are gathering around here. Welcome to Martin Place Metro Station. There are two new platforms, Platform 3 and Platform 4, on Martin Place Station. Platform 3 is towards Sydenham. Now let's take a look at the platform. The platform, as you can see, is super duper long. Platform 4 is pretty much the same too. This is Platform 4, again the same length. Extremely long. Now this platform, as you can see, it is Platform 4, is directed towards Tallawong via Chatswood. The new letter number system has been adopted. Along the concourse, there are these things scattered around. Interviews are happening as we speak. A southern concourse has also been built. Let us go to the southern concourse. Now this is the concourse. This is the southern concourse, which is also very, very glorious, new and modern. There are also toilets, as you can see, lifts and much more. Now I asked a few people about these retail spaces.
I would say if I was going to go inside a retail space, I want this to be a McDonald's, slash KFC and Hungry Jack's. Or over here we can have 7-Eleven or this one.
Hey everybody, welcome to the infamous loo review, and this time we're reviewing the unisex toilet, which actually has a lot of features right here, and it is also really big. There is a baby changing station, a sink, which works very nice, a mirror right here. We also have a dry rack. So let's say I get my hands wet. The dry rack works. Also, a toilet with a really weird container. So yeah, that's the infamous booth. Now, let's take a look at the lifts. I will go back down right now. So, this is the lift right here. If I press the platform.
Please stand clear of the doors.
Right, so this is the lift
going down
right now. And I will be going to the platform very. It's actually very, very smooth, this lift. And also a pretty big space as well.
Platform.
And
we're clear of the doors.
Down at the platform level, there are emergency help and evacuation diagrams.
This is a bench. Sit on it. It's very, 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 very hard. Right, I think this is made of sort of metal, concrete. It's very hard. I don't think you'll last 15 minutes waiting here. The other seats, in the ECML.
Whenever you don't know where to go, you've got this here to help you. So, push button for customer information, and for emergencies only, like in case if someone's like bleeding or like feeling sick, you've got here. Thank you.
The space is really calm and ambient for waiting passengers. Now Matthew tells us something really interesting.
Some stuff here. So this is the connection towards the trains, you know, platforms 1 and 2 here at Martin Place.
Yeah.
And you'll notice that the escalators and the lifts, you'll notice that it's all, you know, really red around here. That's because if you go to the old concourse, that's the same colour as you know, the concourse upstairs. So, and you can see here, red, and then it's all clear here. And then you'll notice, no, it's all clear, and then you'll notice it all start to go red. It comes all red here, and with a little bit of red and a lot of sandstone as well. And it's sort of a transition from, you know, from a sandstone style, you know, Martin Place.
Now near the exit, you can find some buttons. I was really happy with Martin Place. Now, let us go up to the southern entrance, which is the exit for this open day. And wow, this is super duper modern. Right now, coming through, we are on the service level once again, back with the free gelato. The plan your trip board is also here. But for now, let's go back to the bottom. Alright, so I have reviewed all of the unisex and the women's toilet right now. But this is the male toilet right now. As you can see, it's substantially smaller than the actual Anglo toilet. However, the toilet looks much more regular. Also, there is the different flush modes. And we've got a compressed, as you can see, it's automated. This is also automated right here. All I can say is it is substantially smaller than the insect one. And now it's time for some unedited raw footage of pure fun.
When's the Westmead video coming?
Failure. And I'm just gonna do it because Jim. If Jim can do it, I can.
There's something in there.
If Jim can do it.
Actually, when's the Westmead video coming? Seriously.
Brr.
When I get internet.
Brr.
Fingers in the door, please.
Save
in
the day.
The car. Are you coming in or out, my friend? Brace you up. I think the door's broken.
Nah, we can fix it.
Ah.
That piercing sound is so annoying.
No, it's not. See, look, it's calling.
Think positive, guys. Think positive.
Is anyone a praying man? Oh,
there we go. Yay!
Yes!
Yay! Video. Thank you all so much for watching, and bye for now. Also, if you would excuse me, I need to go get gelato.
There are so many people, Jesus Christ.